Hello everyone, I am your produce guy, and today we're out in the garden where I am growing my fresh beans. Now I use a square foot garden method, and so I'm growing a square foot of each different variety of bean. I've got four varieties out here and nine plants in a square. And I want to show you what we've got here. We're going to pick some and maybe have a bite or two of them. Anyway, I'd like to show you the different varieties I've got growing, and let's take a look now. The first variety that I've got here, these are Blue Lake green beans. These are the kind of beans you often see in the store. They're a cylindrical bean. You also see a flat bean in the store. That's called a Kentucky bean. But these Blue Lakes are very popular. I like them, and it's the kind I grow. These are all bush varieties. Of course, there are varieties that have vines, but I like the compactness of these beans. Now we're going to pick these beans generally based on the size. You can pick these pretty much, see this little guy right here? That is, you can pick that and eat it. That would be just fine. But I often pick a little bit on the larger side here, like that. And some of these haven't been picked for a few days, so we get down in here. You can't see it down here, but we'll pull it out. And you see it's a little bit bigger. You want to pick them earlier, first of all, because they're going to be more tender. Second, picking the beans actually encourages the plant to produce more. You can see here, it's got more blossoms up here. It's got another like level of crop coming up here. These blossoms will turn into beans right there. So those are our Blue Lake variety. Now right next to them, let's push this back here. See if you can see right in here. There we are. Those are our purple beans. Now these are really, really pretty fun. They grow kind of flat like that. You can see a beautiful purple color. However, when we cook these up, they're going to turn green, kind of a darker green, different from the Blue Lakes, but they'll end up green on the plate. So any of these beans can be eaten fresh. You don't have to cook them at all. And you usually like to pull off the two little ends or cut them off with a knife so that those are tough and you're not going to want to eat those. But cooked some up last night and we left the ends on because I was kind of lazy and just picked them off as we ate them. But if you're having company or something, you'll want to trim those off. Our next variety is an Italian sort of bean. These are called Romas. And you can see it's another green bean, but very flat pod, not cylindrical at all. These are one of my favorites. I like them. They have a nice, hearty flavor. And they cook up beautifully. They remain firm as you steam them up. I like to steam my beans, not boil them. You can boil them, of course. But steaming just seems to do the right trick, 5 to 7 minutes. Maybe leave the lid on for a few minutes as the pot cools down, and they'll be ready to go. So there's my Romas. The last one, which is my favorite, I've saved the best for last. Right in here, I've got some yellow beans. Now, I love these guys, first of all, because they're not green. That's why I like the purple ones, too. They're not green. But these stay yellow as you cook them. And you can see they're a little tinier than the other beans. They do have that cylindrical body of the bean pod there. But they're by nature, they're more tender than the other beans. Now, any of these beans, as you pick them young, of course, the younger you pick them, the more tender they're going to be. But these yellow beans, they remain tender, until they get to a really mature stage where you can tell the beans are too mature when you start seeing the seeds, the bean seeds inside are outlined in the pod. They're getting to a stage where they're going to be a little bit tougher and they're a little bit past where you really want them. So you want them with the pod still smooth. And there we are. These look beautiful. Sometimes they don't make it into the house. So here's this morning's harvest. We've got our Roma Italian beans, those flat green ones. Right next to them, the purple beans, which also are a little bit flat. My favorites, the yellow beans right there, and our Blue Lake variety like you see in the store right there. That's all out of 4 square feet. Now we've harvested this morning a total of about 2 pounds, I think, here. Quite a bit of beans, more than we can eat, so I'm going to share some of those beans with the neighbors. They will appreciate that, I do believe. The preparation on this is just so simple. We're going to take off the bottom and the top, which are the tough parts, throw them in the steamer, and then they come out and with a little bit of butter or olive oil, salt and pepper. Oh, just really good, really good. So if you haven't experienced growing your own fresh beans, you really ought to. Very productive. As again, 4 square feet has grown all of these beans, and there's more beans on the plants, and it's going to be producing for a couple more weeks. So a great time of year when that bean harvest comes on. For those of you who aren't into gardening, I gotta tell you how satisfying it is to be able to walk out the back door and pick a bowl of fresh green beans like this and know that those plants are making more for another time. It's just great. It really is true. Fresh is best. Everything we need Do I need anything else? I don't think I need anything else. Oh, that's one thing that you can use to break down your. Oh gosh.